everyone, it's Ken LaRue from the Shotgun Team, and here's our tip for the day in our 30 Tips in 30 Days. This tip is going to focus on RV, and I'm going to discuss the different hotkeys you have for playing back and navigating to different frames within your sequence and your medium. So I've got RV already launched, and you can see by looking at the timeline, I've got several different clips that are available to me inside the sequence. Below the timeline, we have our different playback controls. If we want to play forward, we click the forward play button, right? We want to play backwards, we click the play backwards button. Pretty straightforward, you click it again to stop. We also have the ability to navigate frame by frame by clicking on these little buttons right here to the left of the playback controls. And then we also have the ability to jump to marked areas, such as the first frame of each clip, using these different buttons right here to the right of the playback button. And before we start playing back the sources and the clips here, I also should point out that you have the option right here in the lower right corner to determine your playback mode, whether it's going to be playback once, whether it's going to be loop, or whether it's going to be ping pong. These options are also available from your control menu, where you can play and stop, and also set the playback preference of ping pong, play once, step forward, step backwards, and reverse. So these are all available here, but I want to use hotkeys to do this. So that's what the point of this video is. Now, as far as playback, there's two sets of hotkeys that do exactly the same thing. And I think they're both there. So depending upon how you like to work on your keyboard, that you have the option to do either one. First one we're going to talk about is the spacebar, the comma, and the period key. First, I'll hit the home key to go back to my first frame. Then I'll hit the spacebar. This starts the playback. Hit the spacebar again. It stops the playback. Pretty straightforward, right? I'm going to hit the spacebar once again. Now, it's playing back and it's playing forward. If I hit the comma key, I start the playback going backwards. If I hit the period key while it's playing back, it starts to play forward again. So I can use the spacebar to start and stop my playback, and use the comma key and the period key to control the direction of the playback. Now, typically, I'm using my left hand for that. But if I'm going to use my right hand, I might want to use the up and down arrow keys because they do the same thing. I'll hit the down arrow key, which starts the playback, and then I'll hit the up arrow key, which switches the playback to start playing back backwards. Hit the up arrow key again, I start playing my frames and my clips forward again. I hit the down arrow key, I stop the playback. So as I said, those two combinations of hotkeys do exactly the same thing, but they're located in two different places, and you can use either one that makes you feel more comfortable, or use them both. You can also use your left and right arrow keys to navigate frame to frame. So I'm clicking on my right arrow key and I'm moving forward frame by frame. If I click my left arrow key, I start going backwards frame by frame. Now, if you're using a three-button mouse with a wheel, you can also use that wheel to scrub through your frames. So I've got my mouse right here, and I'll start rolling the wheel. And depending if I go backwards or forwards with that wheel, I'm going to scrub frame by frame, one at a time, with my wheel. Now, if we add some modifier keys, such as the control key on Windows or Linux, or the command key on the Mac, I'm going to jump every 5 frames as I scrub the wheel. So that's holding command on Mac, control Windows or Linux, and using your wheel on your mouse to jump and scrub every 5 frames. Now if I add control and alt on Windows and Linux, or option and command on the Mac, I jump every 100 frames as I scrub my wheel. And obviously you can just click and drag and scrub your frames down below in the timeline area, or even just inside the viewport, you can go and do that. I'll hit the home key, which takes me to the very first frame, and you can also hit the end key to take you to the last frame. I'll hit the home key again to go to the first frame to show you my next hotkey. If I want to jump to a specific frame, I hold shift and hit the G key. Now you'll see it reads go to frame. If I enter 12 and hit the return or the enter key, I will jump to the 12th frame. You can enter any amount of frames that you want and you will jump to that frame in your sequence or within your clip. So that's shift G, enter your frame you want to jump to, hit enter or return. The last little navigation hotkey I want to talk about in this video tip is the ability to jump to the first frame of each clip that is in my sequence. I could do that by holding the Alt key on Windows and Linux, or the Option key on the Mac, and using my right arrow key, I can now start jumping to the first frame of each clip that is in my sequence. Holding the Option or Alt on Windows and Linux, I'll use my left arrow key, and I can jump to the first frame of the previous clip. So those are our playback options and hotkeys that we have available inside of our V. And that's our tip for today and our 30 tips in 30 days.